Hey everyone, this is Bhargav Sudhar, and today we are going to learn about partial order relation. Now in this today's session, we will discuss what is a partial order relation, what is a poset, and some of the examples. Okay, so first let us understand what is a partial order relation. So let us understand the definition. Now let capital R be a relation in a set A. Okay, then R is said to be a partial order relation on A if and only if the first one, R has to be a reflexive relation. Now what is a reflexive relation? So that is, for every A belongs to A, this A is related to itself, or that means A is related to A, or this ordered pair AA belongs to R. Okay, so the first step or the first condition is R has to be a reflexive relation. Second, R is an antisymmetric relation. Now what is an antisymmetric relation? So what is the condition? So if AB belongs to R and BA belongs to R, then A and B both has to be same. Okay, so A equals to B, or in other words, AB belong, if A is related to B and B is related to A, then A and B has to be same. So this is antisymmetric relation. And the third one, so R has to be a transitive relation. Now what do you mean by transitive relation? That is, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, then AC, this ordered pair AC, has to be belongs to R. Or in short, if A is related to B, B is related to C, then A and C has to be related. So for partial order relation, the relation has to be a reflexive relation, an antisymmetric relation, and also a transitive relation. Now what is the main difference between this equivalence relation and partial order relation? So in equivalence relation, R has to be reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, whereas in this partial order relation, R has to be reflexive, an antisymmetric, and transitive relation. Okay, so let us discuss example. Now the question is, let capital N be a set of natural numbers. We all know that. So, and R is a relation defined on the set capital N, S. It is defined as like this, this set of all AB such that, we all know what is this notation, A divides B. Now A is related to B, this if and only if A divides B. So this is the relation. Now show that this is a partial order relation. Okay, so for every A belongs to capital A, for partial order relation, the first step is it has to be a reflexive. So for reflexivity, this A divides A, so that means A divides itself, so that means AA belongs to the given relation. So hence R is a reflexive relation, as every number divides itself, okay, belongs to R. So it is a reflexive relation. Now for AB belongs to N, for this antisymmetricity, okay, let us take two points, A, B, and both belongs to N. So for AB belongs to N, if A is related to B, let us consider, if A is related to B, B is related to A, then both are same. Okay, so if A is related to B, so we are assuming that A is related to B and B is related to A, then this A divides B and B divides A by the definition. Okay, now and both are in natural numbers. So if A divides B and B divides A, then both are same. Now you can check for any numbers belongs to set of natural numbers, so both are same, so that and AB belongs to N. So hence R is an antisymmetric relation. And for the third one, for transitivity, we need to have three points. So let ABC belongs to N. So let us assume if A is related to B and B is related to C, then we need to check A is related to C. Okay, so if A is related to B, so that means A divides B, and B is related to C, so that means B divides C. Then we can say that A divides C. You can check for any numbers. For example, 2 divides 4, 4 divides 8, so 2 divides 8, so A divides C, and it is true for any numbers belongs to N. So A is related to C. So hence R is a transitive relation. So since it is reflexive, antisymmetric, and transitive, so it is a partial order relation. Now let us discuss another example. Question is, S equals to 1, 2, 3, and P of S. Now what is P of S? That is a power set of S, and obviously it contains 2 raised to 3 elements. Here we have 3, so 2 raised to 3, that means 8 elements. So that is 5, singleton 1, 2, 3, then 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Now R is a relation defined on a set P of S. Now, A is related to B if and only if the relation is given. A is a subset of B. Then show that it is a partial order relation on P of S. Okay, the set is given P of S, then and the relation is this subset relation. So first we will check whether it is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive. So we know that every set, it is a subset of itself. Okay, so therefore A is a subset of A itself. So hence it is a reflexive relation. So R is a reflexive relation. Now let A is related to B and B is related to A. This is for antisymmetricity. So if A is related to B and B is related to A, let us assume. So then we can say that A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A. So by basic subset relations, we know that if both are subsets of each other, then both the sets are same. So then we can say that this A equals to B. Okay, so hence it is an antisymmetric relation. For the third one, let A is related to B and B is related to C. So that implies by the definition, A is a subset of B and B is a subset of C. Okay, so again by the property, A has to be a subset of C. Just correct it here, A is a subset of C. So hence A is related to C. So we are done. So hence it is a transitive relation. Why? Because A is related to B, B is related to C, then A is related to C. So it is a transitive relation. So since it is reflexive, antisymmetric and transitive, so we can say that it is a partial order relation. Note, the relation this less than or equals to, it is a partial order relation on the set of real numbers. Okay, and in same manner, the relation greater than or equals to, it is also a partial order relation on the set of real numbers. Now let us discuss important topic. What is aposet? That means partial ordered set. Now let capital A be any non-empty set and R be a relation, and obviously it has to be a partial order relation on a set A. Okay, now a set A along with or together with this partial order relation is called a partial ordered set, or in short it is a poset. And this ordered pair, this AR, okay, see this AR is a poset. So it is simple, the set has to be a non-empty and a relation defined on the set. Okay, it has to be a partial order relation. Okay, then just together with it is a poset. Examples, S is a non-empty set and P of S, we just discussed, it is a power set of S. Then the relation, the subset relation, it is a partial relation on the set P of S. So hence this P of S, that is the set, and a relation, the relation is this subset relation. It is this together known as a poset or simply partial ordered set. Now next example, if A is related to B, if and only if this A divides B, it is also a partial order relation on the set of natural numbers. So hence this set, that is the set of natural numbers, and the relation, that is this divides relation, it is also a poset. Note, this relation less than or equals to, it is a partial order relation on R. Okay, now hence generally this less than or equals to, it is used to denote relation on a set A as partial order relation, and this A is less than or equals to, it is a poset. Just it is a poset. Let us discuss example. Draw the diagram for the following relation and determine whether the relation is reflexive, symmetric, transitive and antisymmetric, and is it a poset. Okay, the set is given, A is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so 1 to 8 is given, and X is related to Y whenever this Y is divisible by X. So simply X is X divides Y. Okay, so the solution is, here we have given A equals to from 1 to 8, so 8 elements are there. Now we need to check the reflexivity, symmetricity, transitivity and antisymmetricity, and also we will conclude whether it is a poset or not. Okay, so the relation is R equals to this. How? See, each and every number divides itself. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, up to 8, 8 will be there. And then 1 divides each and every number. So 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 5, up to 1, 8 will be there. Then 2 divides 4. So 2, 4, 2, 6 and 2, 8 will be there. Then 3 divides 6. So 3, 6 will be there. Then 5, then 4 divides 8. So 4, 8 will be there. And that's it. Okay, so these many entries will be there in the given relation. Now here, R is a reflexive. How? Because we know that each and every number divides itself. So for every A belongs to A, this A, the ordered pair A is related to itself, or to be precise, it divides itself. So it is a reflexive relation. Now, is it a symmetric relation? No, it is not a symmetric relation. So if it is not a symmetric relation, then we need to have a counter example. So can you give it? Yes, you can see that. See, 1, 2 belongs to R. So that means 1 divides 2. So 1 divides 2. So 1, 2 belongs to R. But for symmetricity, what we need to check, if A is related to B, then B has to be related to A. Okay. So here you can see that 1, 2 belongs to R. So that means 1 divides 2, but 2 does not divide 1. So that means this ordered pair 2, 1 has to be there for proving the symmetricity. But here it is not the case. So you can see that 2, 1 pair is not in the given relation. So hence it is not symmetric relation. Okay. Now third one, is it a transitive relation? Yes, it is a transitive relation. You can check for any pairs. Okay. Let us discuss. See, 1 divides 2 and 2 divides 4. So 1 2 2 4, so 1 4 has to be there. It is there. Yes, it is there. And in similar manner, you can check for any pairs. Now, is it an antisymmetric relation? Yes, it is an antisymmetric relation, because divides relation, it is an antisymmetric relation. So you can check for any numbers. Now, what will be the digraph? See, for digraph we have 8 points, so just consider 8 points. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 and 7 and 8. Now, what is the relation? We are not writing it. Okay, so we are just directly drawing the digraph. So we have taken all the points. Now see, each and every number divides itself, so there has to be a loop. Okay, so 1 divides 1, 2 divides 2, 3 divides 3, 4 divides 4, 5 divides 5, 6 divides 6, 7 divides 7, and 8 divides 8. So that's it. This 8 pairs are done. Now just consider 1, fix 1. Now 1 divides each and every point. Okay, so 1 divides 2. So 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, 7, and 1, 8. Okay, so this many edges will be there. Now just go for 2. Okay, so 2 divides 4, 2 divides 6, and 2 divides 8. So 3 edges will be there. This 2, 4, 2, 6, and 2, 8. Then 3. Just take 3. Now 3 divides 6. Okay, so 3, 6 will be there. Fine. Now take 4. Now 4 divides 8. So this 4, 8 has to be there. This 4 divides 8. So 4, 8. Now 5 does not divide anything. 7 does not divide anything. 6 and 8. So that's it. So this will be the digraph. Okay. Thank you.